So here we are at the bridge between continents. This is the place where the tourists come to see the Earth cracking apart and the boundary between the Eurasian and the North American plate. It's also a beautiful place to see cross sections through Pahoehoe flows. So if you look immediately opposite me, there's a hummock. You can see this is a beautiful cross section through a tumuli where you can see there've been lava tubes pushing along underneath the layers and forcing up a mound. And you can see the other layers of Pahoehoe. Again, this classic Pahoehoe morphology of, you know, sheets of a few tens of centimeters. We'll go down into this channel and have a look at what the Pahoehoe looks like up close in cross section. Down in here, you can see evidence here that this was once full of lava and that the level of the lava actually drained down, leaving a little coating of lava here in front of us on the edge and kind of bathtub rings. But if we get up in close here, we can see how individual sheets of lava are actually quite thin. You can imagine each one of these individual sheets of Pahoehoe was when this lava flow channel overflowed, it filled up, and lava poured out over the top, just like a river bursting its banks. You can see these individual layers of Pahoehoe giving this very characteristic layered appearance. So in front of me here we've got piece of Pahoehoe, and you can see the ropey layers. And as we get up close up, we've got we're still on the spatter cone, and here we can see some of the details of the spatter that built up these cones that were the vents to feed these Pahoehoe lavas.
Yeah, and one of the things that you see and you feel when you take up a rock is that it's very lightweight. You see all the bubbles here as well. And this is because it's very, very gaseous that have come out here. So this is very indicative of being close to the vent region. Another thing that is very typical for being close to the vent region are the very colorful cinder and spatter that we have here. The red stuff here is oxidized, so you have oxidized iron, and then you have various others having a little bit of fluid structures because it was still partly fluid when it landed.
Now that's brilliant, and you can really imagine that this chain of cones of all these spatter cones that are erupting and splattering up close.